Cryptomator versus VeraCrypt. Which one do you want? Hi, everyone. Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. When would I choose VeraCrypt over Cryptomator? Or vice versa? They both do the same thing, right? Encryption? Yes and no. There's encryption, and then there's how you organize what you've encrypted. While the two tools both encrypt your data, where they differ is how they organize and store your encrypted data on disk. We'll start with VeraCrypt. The VeraCrypt model is what I'll call monolithic. It takes all of the files that you want to encrypt and places them into a single encrypted file. You create a special container called a vault or a volume using VeraCrypt. You choose how large that volume will be based on the amount of data you want to encrypt. For example, I might have, say, 80 gigabytes of data that I want to keep secure, so I might create a 100 gigabyte VeraCrypt volume, so I've got a little bit of extra breathing room. When you create that volume, you assign it a passphrase that is used to encrypt the data. The vault itself, however, is just a large file that, to all appearances, just contains random data, because everything inside of it is encrypted. To actually use the container, you then instruct VeraCrypt to mount it, specifying the passphrase that you set when you created the volume. Mounting creates a virtual disk drive that exposes the encrypted contents of the volume in unencrypted form. In this example, drive V has appeared after mounting the VeraCrypt volume, /folder/myvolume.tc. The contents of the encrypted container then appear as unencrypted files on the V drive in Windows File Explorer. As long as the container is mounted, the contents are directly accessible to basically all programs running on your machine. You've opened VeraCrypt's one big encrypted file to access all of the individual files within it. If you don't mount, or after you dismount the container, all that remains visible is the volume itself, /folder/myvolume.tc, which appears to contain only random noise, which is in fact exactly what encrypted data should look like. Now, Cryptomator, I would call an incremental or individual encryption tool. It stores encrypted files as individual encrypted files. In concept, it's kind of similar to VeraCrypt. I get that. To use a Cryptomator vault, you specify a folder, though, that's going to contain the encrypted data. The folder itself isn't encrypted, but rather will contain the individually encrypted files. When you create that vault, again, you specify a passphrase that's then used to encrypt the data you place into that vault. Much like VeraCrypt, you mount the volume, specifying the passphrase to unlock it. And much like VeraCrypt, this creates a virtual disk that exposes the encrypted contents of the volume in unencrypted form. In the example here, drive M has appeared after mounting the Cryptomator volume, /secret folder. There's no single encrypted container file holding everything. The files themselves are individually encrypted and stored within this folder. The contents of the encrypted container appear as unencrypted files on the M drive in Windows File Explorer. As long as the container is mounted, the contents are directly accessible to all of the programs running on your machine. If you don't mount, or after you dismount the container, all that remains visible are the individually encrypted files with random names organized in random subfolders. Each file's contents appear as random noise, and the file names and folder structure are completely hidden. Okay, which one do you want to use? You can use either of them, of course, but there's a big difference between monolithic and incremental storage. Let's say you want to encrypt the data that you're about to place in cloud storage services like OneDrive or Dropbox. Using VeraCrypt, you place the monolithic vault somewhere within your PC's cloud storage folder. Now, anytime anything changes within the VeraCrypt vault, no matter how small, the entire vault is synchronized to cloud storage and possibly replicated to other PCs sharing the storage. If you make any change to even a single file, like say v:\folder/secretdocument.docx, then the entire c:\folder/myvolume.tc vault needs to be uploaded. If that vault is 100 gigabytes, even the smallest change requires that the entire 100 gigabytes be uploaded. And yeah, that can take some time. Using Cryptomator, on the other hand, you specify a folder in your PC's cloud storage folder as the vault. Anytime anything changes within the vault, only the files that were changed need to be uploaded. For example, if you make a change to a single file, like m:\folder/secretdocument.docx, then only the encrypted file representing that document, which would be secret folder and some random folder with some random name, is uploaded. Nothing else. Much faster. Bottom line is, Cryptomator is a great solution for encrypting files you want to place in online storage management utilities such as OneDrive, Dropbox, and many others. VeraCrypt, or Windows Own Encryption Program BitLocker, probably remains a better choice for encrypting offline data or entire hard disks, though you can certainly use Cryptomator for this purpose as well. Important, this is something you absolutely need to remember. Neither of these tools have backdoors. There is no recovery mechanism should you lose your password. If you lose your password, you lose access to all the encrypted information. I recommend you go one step further and back up your unencrypted data separately in some other secure way. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/178308. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.